why didn't you just get it?
Because of the, if you're an expert on masonry, which I am, you see that in the higher degrees of Freemasonry, that you must support the brother, even in the context of treason and murder. And Masonry is a very weird thing. It predicates on the 33 vertebrae of your spine, 33rd degree being the highest degree, where we find Edward VII, where we find the Duke of Clarence. Here's another one, Duke of Clarence. There's this ridiculous stuff a few years ago about the Duke of Clarence, the Queen's grandson, was Jack the Ripper, he was also a very senior 33rd degree Freemason. So I researched this back. A guy called Stephen Knight wrote a book about the Duke of Clarence being Jack the Ripper, and Freemasonry came down on it like the proverbial tongue of Brits on this thing. How dare you accuse us? How dare you accuse us? I trace back where Stephen Knight, this is why this thing took 15 years, where he got this idea that the Duke of Clarence may have been Jack the Ripper. And it came from, guess who, a very senior Freemason who had leaked it out and buried it and then denied it. The reason being, it was an inoculation against anyone going after Freemasonry. I.e., you go after the Duke of Clarence, and he couldn't possibly have been Jack the Ripper because he was in Balmoral on the night of the double event. Take Freemasonry, and you're going to look like a banana. And that is the reason they did this thing with the Duke of Clarence. Pick up any Ripperology book now, and you'll see a sentence something like, oh, now the Freemasonic angle is being comprehensively debunked. Debunked by who? Everything the Masons say implodes like a line of bloody balloons. I mean, it hasn't been debunked. It's still this cardboard armor around this most repugnant of psychopaths. Unbelievably evil man, the Ripper, whose name escapes me.